Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching Fruitake. OnePlus has finally started rolling out OxygenOS 16 to all eligible devices for Indian users, and the update will gradually reach everyone, including users in India, in the EU and global regions. We have already covered almost every small details of OxygenOS 16 through our in-depth review series. All video links are available in the description below. Today we are bringing you the first video on the YouTube that compares the performance and the battery life of OxygenOS 16 against the OxygenOS 15 featuring OnePlus Nord 5. Unlike many channels that reviews the features and moves on, but we deep dive into the every aspects, this video will serve as the baseline for all OnePlus devices that receive the OxygenOS 16 update, so you can get the clear idea whether battery life and the performance have been improved in this version or not. Before proceeding, a small request to all viewers: if you find our content useful, then please like and hype this video as much as possible. Your support motivates me to keep creating helpful content like this. Now without further delay, let's get started. In this video, we will be testing the performance of latest stable OxygenOS 16 version 300 on OnePlus Nord 5. We will run the Geekbench and Antutu benchmark test and will compare the scores with those from older OxygenOS 15 version. First, I ran the Geekbench test in both balance and performance modes. In the history section, you will see the OxygenOS 15 V603 results were got on November 17. While the latest OxygenOS 16 tests were conducted today on the December 1st, 2025. With balance mode, OxygenOS 15 V603 given the score of 1899 and 4558 for the single and multi-core respectively, while the new OxygenOS 16 have the score of 1901 and 4780. With performance test, old OxygenOS 15 version got the score of 1937 and 4781. While the latest OxygenOS 16 got the score of 1921 and 4923 for the single and multi-core CPU scores test respectively. Let's check out the GPU graphics test results. With balance mode for OpenGL graphics API test, old OxygenOS 15 version got the score of 9478, while new OxygenOS 16 have the score of 9514. While for Wukong graphics API, old OxygenOS 15 got the score of 10208, while new OxygenOS 16 have the score of 10226. With performance mode for OpenGL graphics API test, old OxygenOS 15 got the score of 9442, while new OxygenOS 16 have the score of 9502. While for Wukong graphics API, old OxygenOS 15 got the score of 10026, while new OxygenOS 16 have the score of 10338. If you check the both the CPU and the GPU graphics test score, the clear winner of Geekbench test result is OxygenOS 16, while OxygenOS 15 slightly lagging behind the OxygenOS 16 test scores. But you will surprise when I will show you the Antutu benchmark test results. The first test was done with the balance mode and I got the score of 16,88,318. Old OxygenOS 15 V603 had the score of 14,34,656. So here we got the huge boost of 2,53,662 points. Device CPU temperature rose from 40 to 47 degrees Celsius. Total 6.8% temperature rise was happened during this test. Device felt warmer, but still its performance was intact. It was ran smoothly even after this test. Next, I did the Antutu benchmark test with the performance mode enabled. Here again, I got the huge boost in the scores. We got the score of 17,49,304, while old OxygenOS 15 had the score of 14,50,653. Total 2,98,651 point boost I noticed here. Temperature of CPU rose from 38 to 47 degrees Celsius. Total 9% CPU temperature rise were happened during this test. After performance test, as device temperature rose, it started to feel laggy for few seconds. I felt some animation jitters, scrolling lag, delayed touch response. But once the temperature of the device stabilized down, it started to feel smooth again. So both of the benchmark testing applications like Geekbench and Antutu proved that the latest Oxygen 16 did huge numerical scores boost as compared to old Oxygen 15. Oxygen 16 not only have the better numerical scores but also have amazing performance because of the new flow motion parallel processing. Everything is flowing at the fingertips while using day-to-day activities. So I can definitely conclude that Oxygen 16 is better than Oxygen 15 in terms of performance. But main question arises in the lots of users' mind is that what is the impact of performance over the battery drain? Let's check out the battery life of OnePlus Nord 5 running with Oxygen 16. Here I have the screenshot of battery results from 100 to 2% battery drain. I use the device with balance mode, all the basic functions like Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, GPS always on display were kept on during this stage. As per AccuBattery application from 100 to 2% battery drain, I got 33 hours of total usage time, that is nearby 1 day and 9 hours. Screen on time was 9 hours and 24 minutes, which is insane. Screen off battery drain was just 1% per hour. As I use the device as my daily driver, I have a huge list of applications, but especially I use my Nord 5 to write the scripts for my YouTube videos using Google Keep application. That's why it's top on the list. I also compared the results of Oxygen 16 with battery life of old Oxygen 15, where I got the total 1 day of usage with 7 hours of SOD. Screen off battery drain was 1.6% per hour. So definitely little, but the good improvement of the battery life is done by OnePlus by optimization of Oxygen 16. Note that these battery results I got after average uses of my device. If you are a heavy user, results may downgrade at least by 30% as shown in this video. Battery health of my device is up 99%, so battery results are good on my device. If your device battery health is low, you may get low battery life. So after comparison of both performance and the battery life of Oxygen 16 with Oxygen 15, I can say OnePlus did the great job with optimization of Oxygen 16. As per my recommendation, or Nord 5 and other devices which got the Oxygen 16 update must try this update and give your battery life and the performance review with 3 different ratings like best, average and bad. So all viewers who will watch this video will get clear idea how is the Oxygen 16 battery life and performance. In upcoming days, I will release the same review video for OnePlus 12R and 13R. So stay tuned to our channel. If you think this video is useful, then please like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to OnePlus and OxygenOS. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.